Peter Schmeichel was a Danish professional footballer who played as a goalkeeper. Throughout his career, he was widely regarded as one of the greatest goalkeepers of all time, earning numerous accolades and rewards. With his imposing presence, quick reflexes, and exceptional shot-stopping abilities, Schmeichel was a dominant force in the penalty area and a key figure in the success of his clubs and national team. But was he really that good? Before we answer this, we want to encourage our viewers to choose the topic of our next video. If you have any good ideas, use the link in the description to submit a video title so we know what our audience is looking for. Let's start from the beginning. Peter Schmeichel was born in a multicultural family in Søbrogade Parish, Gladsaxe, Denmark. His father was Polish while his mother was Danish. The legendary footballer inherited his second name, Bolshaw, from his great-grandfather. During his formative years, Peter lived in the town of Buddinge in Copenhagen and began playing football at the young age of 8 for a team in the near suburb of Høje Gladsaxe. He made his debut on the 7th of August 1972, starting a 2.5-year unbeaten run that caught the attention of Hero, a team several divisions above Høje Gladsaxe. Hero had one of the largest youth football schemes in Denmark, and they merged with Gladsaxe to form Gladsaxe Hero BK. This opened up new opportunities for Peter as he was selected to play for the Zealand's FA Juniors representative team. Peter Schmeichel advanced to the Gladsaxe Hero senior squad, he was introduced to his first mentor, Svend Arge Hansen, the club's first team coach. Despite Gladsaxe Hero's relegation from the Danish 3rd Division with only 3 games left, Hansen promoted Schmeichel and 6 other members of the youth team to a match against Birkerød. Though the team lost 1-0, Schmeichel's personal performance earned him recognition in local newspapers. Before becoming a professional footballer, Peter Schmeichel had to work various jobs to make a living. He started as a dyeing department worker in a textile factory, but eventually quit due to safety concerns. He then took a job as a cleaner at an old people's home for a year before moving on to work for the World Wildlife Fund. He initially worked in one of the organization's shops, but after 3 weeks, the store manager resigned and Schmeichel was promoted to the position of sales manager. However, he was soon called upon to complete his 4 weeks of compulsory military service, which coincided with Vidor's summer training camp in Portugal. Despite being granted permission to attend the training camp with the obligation of completing his military service for the following month, the complex situation between the WWF, the Danish Defense Department, and Vidor left Peter to leave the WWF. He then worked for his father-in-law's flooring firm, but had to quit due to knee issues that prevented him from standing for 8 hours a day. He was then offered a job at an advertising firm owned by Vidor's chairman, Niels Erik Madsen, and this was his last job outside of football before being offered a contract with Brøndby the following spring. At the end of the season, Hansen shared his vision for Peter's future with him, which involved 2 more seasons with Gladsaxe Hero, followed by a move to Vidor, a place on the Danish national team, and finally a successful career abroad. Peter revealed that he had received an offer to play for B1903's youth team, but he declined as the club seemed uninteresting to him. The following season, Gladsaxe Hero only needed to avoid defeat against Abakobing to avoid relegation from the Danish National League. Schmeichel put in a phenomenal performance, helping his team secure a win. At the end of the game, Hansen's daughter Bente ran onto the pitch to give Schmeichel a hug. The two started dating and eventually got married. In the world of football, it is not often that you see a goalkeeper straying from his designated area to venture to the opposing team's penalty box. This high-risk move is often seen as a desperate attempt with little chance of success. However, there was one night in Barcelona that defied all expectations and saw a Danish legend abandon his post to be a catalyst for one of the greatest finishes in football history. Although he did not score the winning goal, nor did he even come into contact with the ball, his presence on the field was pivotal in securing the Champions League trophy in 1999. Without him, the outcome of that match and the inscription next to the year 1999 in the Champions League record books would have been vastly different. The moment in Barcelona was a fitting conclusion to Peter Schmeichel's tenure at Manchester United, showcasing that a goalkeeper is much more than just the number of saves and clean sheets they keep. With his towering stature of 6'4" and weight of 16 stone, Schmeichel was a commanding presence in the penalty area, but it was his exceptional agility and reflexes, combined with his commanding demeanor and leadership skills, that set him apart from his peers and elevated him to the status as one of the greatest goalkeepers of all time. He had an innate ability to intimidate even the most prolific of strikers and follow up his intimidating presence with spectacular saves. So when he charged forward in that match against Bayern Munich in Catalonia, there was no doubt in anyone's mind that he would make a crucial impact. And he did. With a thundering aerial challenge just 3 seconds later, the score became 1-1. While other goalkeepers also commanded a presence in the penalty area, such as Tony Schumacher, it was Schmeichel's fear factor that set him apart. Without the need for dangerous or violent challenges like Schumacher's notorious near-beheading of Patrick Bettiston. Peter Schmeichel's influence extended not only to the opposing attack, but also to his own defence. He had a unique ability to strike a balance between instilling confidence in his defenders and serving as a disciplinarian, ready to step in if they'd made a mistake. A strong and respected voice behind the defence is crucial in ensuring that even the best individual defenders in the world can perform at their best. It was because of Schmeichel's leadership that Manchester United was able to experience a period of dominance domestically in the 1990s and eventually becoming champions of Europe. The £505,000 investment made in the talented goalkeeper from Bromby paid off handsomely, as he helped lead United to win 5 Premier League titles, 3 FA Cups, a League Cup, and the European Crown. Peter Schmeichel's success on the club level was matched by his remarkable achievements on the international stage with the Danish national team. At the 1992 European Championships, Denmark made history by stunning the continent and winning the tournament. Schmeichel played a critical role in their success, saving a crucial penalty in the semi-finals from Marco van Basten, who had famously won the tournament for the Netherlands 4 years prior with a sensational volley. However, it was in the final where Schmeichel made his biggest impact, albeit in an unexpected way. It was a journey that would leave a lasting impact on the young Schmeichel and ignite his love for international football and the European Championships. Little did he know, just 8 years later, he would be leading the Danish national team to glory and etching his name into the history books as one of the greatest goalkeepers of all time. Having witnessed Denmark's impressive run in the 1984 tournament, Schmeichel sets his sights on one day playing in the competition himself. His tireless hard work and dedication to the sport eventually led him to achieve that goal and more, as he went on to lead Denmark to the ultimate victory in the 1992 European Championships. Such was his unwavering determination to win at all costs that the rules of football were forced to change as a result of his tactics. During the final against Germany, Schmeichel and his defence utilised the practice of passing the ball back to the goalkeeper, which had also been a source of controversy at the 1990 World Cup. Football officials had grown tired of the issue, finally took action and banned the passback rule, which has since become known as the Schmeichel rule. This change in the game was a testament to Schmeichel's competitiveness, as well as his impact on the sport at both the club and international levels. However, even without his competitive edge and gamesmanship, Peter Schmeichel was truly unmatched in his generation as a goalkeeper. He made a series of incredible, seemingly impossible saves that defied the laws of physics, and had a remarkable ability to get to the ball just in time to prevent it from crossing the goal line. His quick reflexes and agility combined with his imposing 6'4" frame made him a formidable presence in the penalty area. He was known for his iconic butterfly technique when facing close range shots, and his saves during the treble winning season with Manchester United are still remembered today, particularly his penalty save against Dennis Bergkamp. However, Schmeichel was much more than just a great goalkeeper. He was a leader, an intimidator, a true game changer who elevated the play of those around him and left a lasting impact on the sport. Despite his incredible achievements, Schmeichel was only named to the PFA Team of the Year once, and his time at Manchester United came to an end a bit too soon. Nonetheless, in his 8 years at Old Trafford, he raised the bar for excellence and set the standard for what is meant to be a top-class goalkeeper. He arrived at the club at the time when they were in the midst of a three-decade league drought, and when he left, they established themselves as the Premier League team in England and one of the top clubs in Europe. This is why Peter Schmeichel is widely regarded as one of the greatest goalkeepers to ever play the game, and why many consider him to be the best of all time. His leadership, competitiveness, and exceptional talent in between the sticks are what makes him a true legend of the sport, and his legacy continues to inspire and influence goalkeepers everywhere.